Hey guys, so a whole bunch of people have been asking me how I made these rocks. So I'm gonna do a tutorial on how I did them. I'll recreate this one for this video. And I might do another video later on showing how to do the full swirl. This one will just be the wave. Alright, so paints, wild grapes, purple pizzazz, this is just regular orange, sorry, keep holding it away from the camera, carousel pink, and then I've got a yellow, this is lemon yellow, and a white. I also have this glazing medium that I'm going to use. This isn't necessary, but my these acrylics are a lot thicker than the ones in the tube, so this is good for making it smoother and making the paint go, I don't know, further. Alright, so I'm going to start with my round brush. And we'll start with the dark purple. So this is the wild grape color. I'm just gonna kind of eye where the center is. So if you wanna sketch it out beforehand, that's cool. I did that with mine whenever I was doing practice runs. And the pencil mark showed through a lot on mine, so if you do that, make sure you go really light on the sketch. All right, so I've got that purple. I'm gonna go ahead and go in with some white. Right next to that. Just creating subtle blending. You want it to be really smooth and just nicely blended. Pleasant to the eye. Alright. Now I'm gonna add some pink. And I'm gonna go on top a little bit of where that light purple was. I'm gonna start blending it down. And taking it out. You want an exaggerated effect. That's what's gonna enhance the swirl. Alright, and here I'm gonna fill in with that other purple that I have. I forget the name of it. Purple pizzazz. This really is just throwing in colors wherever I want, just kind of where I think might look nice. The main thing you want to do is you just want the subtle blend. You know, you want it to look ethereal, kind of, so you really want to give almost like a, I don't know, kind of like a mist effect. Alright, you kind of want to have a center in mind, so this is going to be my center, and I'll show you how I made the actual swirl. But, okay, I'm going to go back in with the darker purple again, and I'm going to make just a line here. Going in with that other purple, giving this a little color difference. Going with my pink, add that in. Again, the pink I'm doing here on top of here is just changing the purple color a little bit. Just want to give it a little bit more effect. purple again. I'm just gonna draw it out. See how this goes out. And from there, I'm gonna add in a little pink. So when I made this rock, I wanted the effect of a wave. So this wave would be closer, this one would be further away, and then kind of like a sky. So I want this wave to be predominantly purple, because since I'm gonna do more pink in the background. So you wanna keep that in mind when you're blending your colors. If you want the same effect that I got. Okay. All right, let's start adding our pink in. So I'm just gonna draw my other line out here, giving it boundary. Oops, I'm putting fingerprints in my paint. And, oops, grab my medium instead of my white. All right, go in with some white. Just giving it whatever effect you want. I'm gonna go in more again with the darker pink. I was giving this time to dry. I'm gonna go back in on this one now. So just putting that dark purple in there. I'm gonna go right beside it with that other purple. And my white. You want constant curvature with your strokes. So I'm constantly thinking about it and moving towards the right. So you want your colors to kind of flow that same way. I'm gonna add a little bit of pink in here. Bring this dark down some more. Following with that curve. Let's cover up my fingerprint there. Now, I'm going to go in with my dark pink, and I'm kind of going to create this center dot of where I want everything to flow into. I'm just kind of defining that line a little bit, but that's going to be my center. All right. I'm gonna give that a minute to dry. Actually, I'm gonna darken it up a little bit more. All right, while that dries, we'll get started on the swirls here in a minute. But while that dries, let's add a little more color in here. give it some white streaks. And a little bit of purple down here, that little purple pizzazz. Not much, just a little. Just so it'll kind of mesh better with the big wave. And let's bring this down a little more. Still creating those colors how I want, just till I'm happy with it. Brush, this is a nail art brush. And I'm gonna get my dark purple. And I'm gonna start in on the swirl, and I hope you can see this. So, I want it to be as thin as possible, okay? I'm just gonna make the swirl pattern. Just however, whatever circle you want. Okay. Then with your pink, you're gonna go inside of that swirl. Okay, so you're just like defining the swirl there. Bringing it down. Into there. I'm gonna go back in with my dark purple. See this swirl? You can keep playing with that until you get it as precise as you want. Alright. I'm gonna, I want it to be a little more swirly, so to do that, again, I hope you can see this. I don't know if it's blurry or not in the video. But I'm going to take my pink in and I'm going to go just a little bit further inside of that, of my dark purple. See how it made the swirl a little bit tighter? So we'll do the background now. So I'm going to use my yellow. I'm going to use my glazing medium to loosen it up a bit. So I want my brighter yellow to be on this side. It's going to graduate into kind of an orange and then fade into a white, whiter, a really light yellow or a white. So I'm going to start on this edge over here. Sorry, I'm getting more yellow. Just gonna bring that over and just eyeball it as far as you want. Start in with my orange. Together. I'm gonna grab some more yellow with the orange still on my brush because it'll kind of automatically blend them together. Still want to keep that same swirl pattern, so you're bringing the colors towards the center, not across. Alright, I'm going to grab some white, apply that, and work it up into the yellow and the orange. I haven't cleaned off my brush yet, so all these colors are naturally just kind of going together. I'm getting a little more white. I want this to be pretty white right here at the mid, at the center. Got a little bit of water on my brush. I'm just gonna kind of blend where it's not quite blended together. Alright, I'm gonna give a little more orange over here. I'm gonna grab some more white to blend. And then this is just a little water on my brush. Alright, now I want to take that white in to my center swirl. I think it would look cool. Alright, so just gonna go right alongside the pink there and the purple line. I'm just trying to do it as small as I can. Actually really hard for me to get close to because, or to not be close to. I'm used to being able to put these right up in my face. It's hard with the camera in the way. And some more white here. I want to smooth out my edge. grab some pink because that white's not finishing that edge very well. I've got, there's bumps in my rock, and so it's making it hard to smooth out there. There we go. All right. I'm going to grab some white again. I'm just going to add in a couple, kind of like white streaks kind of coming down. And then I wiped the paint off my brush and it's just a little wet. Oh no. You don't want to do that. Let me get my other brush. So I'm just going to get my bigger brush. Just go right along that white because I don't want the lines, I just want it blended, and the water will help do that. All right, I'm gonna go back in with that, the lighter purple, and still just building up. I want it to be kind of bright. It'll brighten up. These paints brighten when you seal them. So don't worry about that. It'll be plenty bright. Alright, I'm gonna do a little pink beside that. Pretty happy with it. Let me finish off this edge a little better. So I'm just going to grab my dark purple and where I went over that line with the yellow, I'm going to straighten that out. Seal it, and it'll be good to go. So there they are, side by side.